Today, I'll be sharing some important information for students preparing for the IB math exam. Drawing on my years of experience teaching IB students, I will discuss common mistakes students make and the types of answers the mark scheme expects. If you are preparing for the IB math exam, it is essential that you take a note of this information and apply it to your exam. Number one, the most common mistakes. The most common mistake that students make in IB math exams is regarding significant figures. The exam paper usually requires answers to be given in three significant figures or exact answers, unless otherwise stated. If the answer is 0.001, make sure to write it as 0.00100 to match the required three significant figures. When calculating values on your calculator, if the answer is 1.456789, you must copy and paste the entire value to the next question instead of rounding it to 1.46 with the three significant figures. Using the rounded value for the subsequent questions can lead to a different answer than the one in the answer sheet. Number 2, Formula Boomland. Make sure to use the latest version of a Formula Boomland for your exam preparation. Previous versions such as 1.0, 1.1 may contain errors. Number 3, Sketching Graphs. When drawing a function graph on your answer sheet, make sure to include the following four elements. A, axis intercepts, both on the x-axis and y-axis. B, asymptotes, which can be vertical, horizontal, or slant. C, coordinates of any local maxima and minima if applicable. D, don't forget to include the coordinates of endpoints if the x-domain is specified in the question. It is important to double-check that all four of these elements are included whenever you draw a function graph. Number 4, inverse functions. When finding the inverse function, it is important to use the correct notation to avoid losing marks. If the given function is called f of x, then its inverse function must be denoted as inverse of f of x. Similarly, if the given function is g of x, then its inverse function must be denoted as inverse of g of x. Using any other notation or simply y as the name of the inverse function can result in deduction of marks. Number 5, trigonometric functions. When working with the inverse trig functions, it is important to note that different countries or textbooks may use varying notations. However, IB students must use the notations arcsine x, arccosine x, and arctangent x without exception. In case the question specifies the answer should be in degrees, the answer should be given in degrees. Similarly, if it specifies radians, the answer should be given in radians. Number 6, factors. In vector problems, factors are typically represented in bold font without an arrow. When writing the answer, however, it is important to use the correct factor notation. When the problem asks for the vector equation of a line or plane, it is essential to include the r or xyz on the left-hand side of the equation. Many answers lose a point for omitting these details. Please be cautious. When the problem asks for the coordinates, be sure to write them horizontally, and if it asks for the position vector, write it as a column vector vertically. Number 7, statistics. Normal distribution and binomial distribution problems are often mixed in IB math exams. Be prepared to use normal distribution to calculate a certain probability and then use that probability to solve a binomial distribution problem. Make sure to be familiar with both types of distributions. Don't be surprised if a problem asks you to find the probability of at least 4 successes out of 10 trials after finding a probability with a normal distribution. Just use the binomial distribution. When using a calculator for statistic questions, you will usually receive working marks if your answer is correct. However, if your answer is incorrect and there is no working shown, it will be scored as 0. Therefore, even for calculator questions, it is necessary to write a few lines by hand explaining what is being calculated. This way, even if the answer is wrong, you can still receive partial credit. Here's another great tip for statistics. In normal distribution questions, the problem will clearly state that the variable follows a normal distribution. However, there is no such mention for binomial distribution questions. Even if you just recognize this fact, you will receive 1 point. So be sure to write x follows binomial distribution of np, even if your answer is incorrect, as you can still receive a partial score of 1 point. Boxing risk plot problems has been appearing frequently, along with questions about outliers. To begin with, select a spreadsheet on the first screen. Let's assume that the data name is A and input random values. As the 11th value, we'll input a relatively large value of 18 to make it an outlier. Press the menu button and select 3 for data, then select 8 for summary plot on the right. Change the display on to new page in summary plot and press OK. Now histogram will appear, but we need to change it to box plot. Press the menu button again and select 2 for plot properties, and then choose remove Y variable. Finally, press the menu button again and select box plot under plot type. Now you can see the box plot. Moving the cursor from left to the right, you can see the minimum, lower quartile, median, upper quartile, and maximum. The value 18 on the far right is the outlier. Although the cursor may not be visible on the recorded screen, you can check each value by moving the cursor. 8. Sequences. When solving sequence problems, you may need to find the maximum value. For instance, consider the sequence an equals 1.5n minus 3 times 1.2 to the power of n plus 4, and suppose you want to find the maximum value. Let's say we found the maximum value on the graph to be approximately x equals 5.533, which corresponds to a of n 4.0727. However, this is not the correct answer because the index n of a sequence can only take integer values. Therefore, we must check the cases where x equals to 5 and 6 respectively and choose the larger value as the answer. For this problem, a of 5 is 4.035 and a of 6 is 4.042, so the maximum value is at when n is 6. Remember, in sequence problems, the index n must always be an integer. 9. Differentiation. When solving problems that require finding the point of inflection, you must locate the value where the second derivative of f of x becomes 0 and check for a sign change in the second derivative before and after that value. Simply finding the value where second derivative of f of x becomes 0 will not earn full marks. It is important to read the problem carefully and determine whether you need to find the x value, where the maximum minimum occurs, the maximum minimum value itself, or the coordinates of the maximum minimum. Your answer should be tailored to the problem's requirements. When looking for absolute max mean, there's no need to determine whether the stationary points are maxima or minima. Just plug in the boundary values and stationary points into f of x and find the greatest and the least values. Did you know that with the TI Aspire calculator, you can graph a function that has been differentiated once or twice instantly? There was a problem asking to find the points where the acceleration is 0, given that the displacement is 3 times t plus 3 to the power of cosine t. As you know, it's not easy to differentiate this problem twice by hand. However, if you use a calculator to draw a graph of a second derivative function, you can easily find the answer. In the Marx game, if you find the answer with a graph, you'll be given 3 points. Now let's draw the graph of the second derivative using the calculator. First, press the tab key to prepare to enter the equation. Then press the right button next to the number 9 and select second derivative. Now let's enter the equation. The graph of the second derivative has been drawn. By finding 0 on the calculator, we have found the value where the second derivative equals to 0. 10. Integration. When calculating definite integrals, it is important to always include the integration constant c at the end of your answer. Sometimes you may get points even without including c. You can't rely on luck for your score, can you? Please be sure to include c. If your answer involves a logarithm as a result of integrating a fraction, remember to include the modulus symbol. There are cases where you may lose points for not using modulus as shown on the screen. Please be careful. 11. Counting. When the answer to the counting problem is too large to be calculated accurately by a calculator, it is acceptable to leave the answer in factorial form or write it in standard form. However, if the answer can be calculated by your calculator, as in the example here, it is recommended to write the exact answer. Great! So far, I have covered important topics that you need to know before taking the IB Mathematics exam. I hope that this video was helpful for you. If it was, please subscribe and like the video so that you can stay updated on the future content. I will continue to create helpful videos to assist you in your studies. Thanks for watching today's video. This is your math guardian, Alex, signing off.